Good afternoon everyone. So this video we are going to discuss about module 3 in control engineering subject. So here we are going to discuss about time response as well as root locus. Okay, so normally first part the time response. So here we are going to discuss about transient response as well as steady state response. Okay, first we are going to discuss about time response. So before going into the time response, first we are going to discuss about the introduction of this particular module. So that is the most of the control system, it is time response used as in the independent variable. Okay, time is used as an independent variable, so the control system inherently time domain system. Okay, so therefore the response analysis of a control system has become important factor for the design and analysis of control system. So normally this point you should have to remember. So that is the response analysis of the system is the important factor of design and analysis of control system. So this is the point should remember. Then comes into the next thing. The response analysis means study of the system output behavior of the function of time. Okay, it is the study of the system output behavior of the function of time. Okay, then we have which is subjected to the input, known input, when it is subjected to the known input. So this also known as a time response. Okay, then comes into the next thing. Okay, the time response analysis of a control system helps in evaluating the stability of the system. So normally in this module 3 and module 4 we are going to find the stability of the system only. Okay, so this is the point you have to remember over here, how the system will be stable or not, those things we are going to find over here. Then comes into the time response. If the output of the control system for an input varies with respect to time, then it is called as time response. That means output of the control system for an input varies with respect to time, means that is time response. Okay, so in this time response, next we are going to discuss about there are two parts of time response. One is the transient response and another one is the steady state response. Okay, the time response, that means how the time transient and steady state response, it will be shown in this drawing, will be in the graphical manner. So it will be gradually increases with respect to time. Okay, so that means that is up to certain time it is transient state. Okay, so once it reaches the maximum condition, slowly steadily it will be increases, means that is called it as steady state. So in this diagram it will be showing the relation between transient and steady state. So both the transient and steady state shown here, and the responses corresponding to these states are known as transient and steady state. So here CFT is the output, and it will be varies with respect to the time. Okay, that is the thing they will shown over here. Then comes into the next thing, the time response. Mathematically you can write CFT. Normally we are going to write output as CFS. So okay, here we are going to write in terms of time domain. So CFT is equal to C of that means transition response of T plus steady state, C of steady state into the time domain. Okay, so both this is equal to the output value over here. Okay, so the equation, it will become C of T is equal to C TR of T C SS of T. So here T, it will be indicating of time domain. Already we people know that suppose here S, it will becomes, that will be in the frequency domain. Okay, So these are all the points you should have to remember over here. Then comes into the transient response. And the transient response, after applying the input to the control system, output takes certain time to reach steady state. Okay. So initially, normally in any of the system, if you're applying the load, so normally it will be take to reach the steady state system, it will be gradually increasing. Okay. So it will take certain time. Okay. So the output will be the transient state till it goes to the steady state. So therefore, the response of the control system during the transient state is known as transient response. Okay. So the transient response will be zero for large values of t. Ideally, this value of t infinity, and practically it is 5 times constant. Mathematically, the we can write it as limit tends to infinity to ct transition response t is equal to 0. So and here, so normally the transient state will be gradually increases towards to the steady state response. Okay. So this is the thing is called as transient state. So this is the part we should have to remember over here. So transient response is defined as the part of total time response which decays or dies out or goes out to the zero over a period of time, or time becomes very large after large interval of time. It is denoted by f of t. Okay. So this is about the time response. Now, so normally limits tends to infinity. So y of t is equal to 0. So c of t or y of t is equal to 0. Like this, we are going to represent the transient response. Then comes into the steady state response. The definition of the steady state response. The steady state response is defined as the part of total time response which remains after the transient response has dies out. It is defined as y 2 of t. Okay. So this is about the steady state response. So the part of the time response that remains even after the transient response as zero value for large values of t is known as steady state response. So this means the transient response will be zero even during the steady state. Okay. So once in this this is the point you should remember, transient response will zero over in the steady state. Then comes into this one example. Let us find the transient system and the steady state terms of the time response of the control system. C of t is equal to 10 plus 5 e minus t. So here the second time 5 e minus t will be 0 as t denotes infinity. So this is the transient time. And the first term 10 remains even as t approaches infinity. So this is steady state time. Okay. So this is about the steady state response. So normally in this time response we are going to evaluate the stability of the system. So this is the point you should have to remember over in this time responses. So we have discussed over the transient response as well as the steady state response. Okay. In this the steady state response, okay, so it is the part of time response, so that remains even after transient response zero value for large values of t known as steady state response. Okay. So in the normally in the steady state response, transient response will be zero. So that is also one more point you should remember over here. Okay. This is about the introduction of this particular time response. The remaining thing we will see in the coming classes. Thank you.